welcome back to another video. I am Bortilify, and if you don't know, on December 8th is my 1 year anniversary for this channel, so please like and subscribe in celebration for that. Today, I am doing a very cool video, and as you can see, there's a tier list on the screen that is going to help us with today's video. So today, my phone is ringing. Yes, hello? Hello?
I'm here for a foreign, I'm gonna help you with this video, whether you like it or not.
But I was going to do it by myself.
Nope. Do you not get the whether you like it or not part?
Okay, well, I guess, guys, today in this tier list video, Mr. 404 here is going to help us. So today, I guess we are going to be ranking every box legendary Pokemon. There are many box legendaries out there, and I am going to start off with my tier list for every box legendary out there, and I definitely think that this will stand out from Air 404's, and I just think this is going to be good. So starting off with the first box legendary, and technically this wasn't even a box legendary, is Mewtwo, which I'm going to put in legendary class. Mewtwo is in legendary class because it is an amazing Pokemon, and it's a classic Pokemon. It was introduced in the first game ever, hence why it's the first Pokemon I'm putting on. And what stops it from being mythic class is it's just not as cool as some of the other legendaries that they have introduced. And I think while, yes, its Mega Evolutions are pretty cool, its base form is what I'm focusing on. And its base form is pretty cool. It has a good typing. Good shiny. Definitely good shiny. And its Megas are pretty cool. But overall, I think that it definitely should stay in the legendary class. And going on to the next generation, which is generation 2, which boxes legendaries are Suicune, Ho-Oh, and Lugia. Starting off with Suicune, I'm going to give him a mythic tier because he is my favorite legendary Pokemon ever, which means I am kind of being a little biased, and suck it up because I don't care. His shiny is amazing. And overall, his design is perfect. In the new DLC for Sword and Shield, he can walk on water, which, I mean, unless you are stupid, it's awesome. Yeah. So, moving on to Ho-Oh. I'm going to give Ho-Oh a legendary tier, because I think he's a really good Pokemon. The legendaries in Gen 2 are outstanding, and especially Ho-Oh, and he's shiny. I would say is probably the best shiny legendary in existence. He's just that cool. And I think he deserves legendary status. Next up, we have Lugia, which I'm putting at epic tier, because while Lugia is an amazing Pokemon, I just think he's not as cool as Ho-Oh and Suicune. Well, yes, I could have put him as the same tier as Suicune or Ho-Oh, but I just felt that he was a little step below the two, and I think that he should just refrain down at epic. I think that depending on who you talk to, he could be in legendary and mythic, but this is based on my own opinion, and I think that he should be in epic. So moving on to the Gen 3 Pokemon box legendaries, we have Groudon, Kyogre, and Rayquaza. Now, this is my favorite gen ever, so I'm kind of biased about all of them. But starting off with Rayquaza, I'm going to put him at legendary tier. I'm putting him at legendary tier because, yes, he is an amazing Pokemon, and he is beloved by the fans. In Gen 6, he got an amazing Mega Evolution, and his shiny is, like, amazing. One of the best shiny legendaries out there. But I still think that all of those features is not enough to boost it to mythic status, and as well. We are only discussing about their base form, so I think Rayquaza just should be at legendary status. Moving on to Kyogre. Kyogre, I'm going to give epic status to. While one of my main Gen 3 games, or I guess Gen 6, depending on who you talk to, I guess it's really both, I had Pokemon Alpha Sapphire, and Kyogre was my legendary. While, yes, I kinda have that sentimental value attachment to it, I don't think it's that special, and it's water, and I haven't really been a fan of that many water types, except Suicune, because he is amazing. But I still think that Kyogre, I'm just gonna keep at epic tier. So, moving on to the final one is Groudon, and he's gonna get mythic status. Groudon is a classic fire legendary Pokemon, and he's one of the coolest. He has some amazing signature moves, and his overall just the design is amazing, and his primal form is even better. Now, I do really like his primal form, but again, probably gonna stress this out too much. We're only judging the base forms, and his base form is outstanding, so that's why he gets a mythic tier. Moving on to Gen 4, we got Dialga, Palkia, and Giratina. Starting off with Giratina, I'm going to give him legendary status. We don't have that many epic tiers or rare tiers, or any of the tiers below that. But trust me, we are going to get into some later. I think Giratina is a really cool Pokemon, and being in legendary status is just cool. And his secondary form is cool, but we're basing it off of first form, so yeah. He is amazing. I like his overall design. He just looks like an evil creature out of a comic book. Moving on to Palkia, he gets uncommon status because he's just bad. Palkia, depending on who you talk to, could be their favorite Pokemon ever, but let's be real. Palkia is ugly and kind of disgusting and a disgrace to the Pokemon franchise. He's strong, sure, but is he bad looking? Yes. And that's pretty much all I can say. His face looks like a disgruntled tortoise. I mean, come on. That's why I'm putting him at the uncommon tier. And finally, moving on to Dialga, I'm going to give it epic tier. While I do think Dialga is a really cool Pokemon, it is literally the god of time, which is sick. It's just not that special. It looks cool, don't get me wrong, but it doesn't really have a lot of features that make it go up any more than epic tier. And he is my favorite out of the trio of Pokemon from, or legendaries from Gen 4, but I don't think there is really anything he can do unless he gets a remake game to boost him past the epic tier. Now we're going to move on to the Gen 5 legendaries, which are Zekrom, Reshiram, and then their fusions with Kyurem. Starting off with Black Kyurem, I don't know why I'm starting off with him, but I am. Black Kyurem is going to get a mythic status. Black Kyurem is one of my favorite legendaries ever, and I have him on my team in Pokemon Sword and Shield. He just looks sick. He's big, bulky, and he's half Kyurem, an already amazing Pokemon. But then you add Zekrom onto it, that's just amazing. So then we're gonna go on to White Kyurem. White Kyurem. White Kyurem, I'm going to give rare tier. Because while White Kyurem is cool, but I just don't think he's the same as Black Kyurem. White Kyurem has a small, less bulky look and doesn't look that intimidating, which some people might like, but personally, I don't. So I'm just going to keep him at rare status. Moving on to Reshiram, I'm going to give him an epic status, one step above White Kyurem. Well, White Kyurem is a cool Pokemon. Reshiram is a bit cooler. And I think that honestly they should have just left Reshiram there, so that's why I'm putting him at epic status. Because that's just how it is. Zekrom, on the other hand, I'm going to give legendary status to. He is a beautiful electric-type Pokemon, and if you don't know, electric-types are some of my favorite ever. So, of course, an electric-type legendary is going to be one of my favorites. That's why I'm giving it a legendary class. Its overall design is cool, and I think it just should stay legendary. Now we're moving on to Gen 6, which has Yveltal and Xerneas. Xerneas, I am going to give as rare tier, because it is a really cool deer-looking Pokemon. I like how colorful it is, and its shiny is amazing. It has a cool white design on its shiny, and the colors of its antlers are absolutely amazing. And I just think it should stay as rare tier, because there's nothing that's boosting it up. So, Yveltal is next, and Yveltal is one of my favorite legendaries ever, and he's going to be another Pokemon that is going to receive Mythic class. His design was overall executed perfectly, and he looks like an amazing Dark-type bird Pokemon that we need in the franchise. And overall, I think everyone that plays Pokemon likes Yveltal. He's just sick. And his signature move, Oblivion Wing, is awesome. I also remember him from the movie he was in, and he's just an amazing Pokemon. So moving on to the Gen 7 box legendaries, we have Solgaleo, Lunala, and their fusions with Necrozma. So starting off with Dawnwing's Lunala, Necrozma. I always get them confused. Dawnwing's Necrozma is going to get Mythic tier again. Got back-to-back Mythic tiers. Why I think it deserves Mythic tier is just for the fact that it is amazing and it looks insane fused with Necrozma. I think how they changed the blue and purple color of regular Lunala just fits it really, really well. And that's pretty much why it deserves Mythic class. Okay, guys, now moving on to Duskmane Necrozma. I think it is legendary class. It is a really cool Pokemon, and I do like it, but it's just, to me, not as cool as regular Solgaleo. Kind of like with the white Kyurem situation. So I'm going to give it just a regular legendary status. I think it is a cool Pokemon, but it's just not as good as regular Solgaleo, so it's not going to go in the Mythic tier. And I kind of did give away the next one, but Solgaleo is going to be another Mythic tier. Solgaleo is a really awesome Pokemon, just the one problem I have with it is it's not a fire type, which makes no sense. It's a steel and psychic, which I kind of get, but it needs fire typing. And I just think, yeah, it needs fire typing, and that's why it deserves a Mythic tier. Lunala, on the other hand, is going to go down to Epic tier. Because compared to its fusion form, it's just not good. I don't like the purple color on it, and it's not as good. So it just kind of looks ugly, and I'd rather just have the fusion form of it because it's just not as good. So that's why it's just going to be down in Epic class. Finally, we have our Gen 8 legendaries, and starting off with Zamazenta, I'm gonna give him an uncommon. While I did get Pokemon Shield, and I do kind of like Zamazenta, he's gonna get uncommon, because let's just face it, as much as I have sentimental value to him, he's just not that great in design, and he's going to be uncommon. I do like him, but he's just not that great. I think that he would be a bit better if they just took a little more time to design his character a bit better, and then he would have been amazing. The final Pokemon on this tier list is Zacian. And Zacian is going to get legendary tier. Zacian is an already amazing Pokemon, and I just think it definitely deserves legendary tier. Its sword is amazing, and its overall design is superb. And I think that's all that needs to be said about Zacian. It's just an overall great Pokemon. The video is not over yet. More rankings are to come. In a world full of unranked Pokemon, many have been left out, and all are wondering if Aerofor 4 will make an appearance. In the next installment of this series, we will see Aerofor 4's list compared to mine. New Part 2 to all Pokemon Box Legendaries will be released and is coming to theaters and smartphones near you. So grab a device, subscribe to the channel, and see them. Rated R for ridiculous. Terms and uses may apply. This is copyrighted, so please don't steal it.